The insurance market has experienced growth in 2020, a signal that the sector has withstood the challenges occasioned by COVID-19. The pandemic saw a sharp contraction in public investment and declination in private consumption, which hit the industrial and service sectors hard, particularly the informal sector service.
The last 12 months to December 2020 was challenging for several economic sectors. The slow business activity impacted firms, bottom lines, and the insurance sector was no exception. The industry grew at 9% compared to 13% in 2019, according to the IRA Chief Executive Officer, Alhaji Kadnabi Ibrahim Luega.
In view of COVID, there was slowed business activity, and indeed, many of the investments were not affected as a result of the pandemic. Insurance penetration, which is the contribution of the sector to the GDP, stood at the same level of 0.77%. And this does not mean in any way that the sector is not growing, but it also is as a result of the rebasing which was done on the GDP.
In the year 2020, non-life business generated 664.9 billion shillings compared to 621.9 billion in 2019, representing 7% growth in premiums. The life segment recorded a 32.2 billion shillings in growth written premiums, registering a 17.3% growth.
I also note that the figures which UBOS submitted, they noted reduction in medical insurance. And I want to state it categorically that according to the figures we have, medical insurance did not decline, it actually improved. And the uptake of medical insurance, the figures are evidently available. The third point for this growth was the increased uptake of individual life insurance, which accounted for 55% of the total premiums written in life business. And this is emerging from the increased awareness and the growing middle-class status.
Insurance companies reviewed and cut expenditures to improve operational efficiency and promoted the development of health insurance during the pandemic. Most companies also increased investment in information technology and digital transformation to improve service quality, operational efficiency, and risk management ability. Contrary to the 2019-2020 National Household Survey by the Uganda Bureau of Statistics that indicated that health insurance dropped from 5.1% in 2016 to 2017 to 3.9% in 2019-2020, Kadunabi noted that health insurance uptake rose. Story by Ali Twaha for the news.